Coming to you from twitch.tv/SidLulz with a Z, the It's Late Show with SidLulz, Kai, Cat Tidal Wave, a possible musical appearance from our friend Charlie, featuring Sid Spotify and chat. Tonight's episode. Now here he is, SidLulz!
Good evening, and welcome to the It's Late Show with Sid Lowe.
Hello. Hello, everybody. Hello. Welcome. Welcome to the It's Late Show season finale. I am Sid Lowe's. Can't really see anything going on in chat now. I'm over here. Thank you, Wanderbread, for the sub earlier. 12 months. It's been a year. Been a year of getting the Twitch grind on. It's been fun, though. It's been a lot of fun. But we're at episode 7. Episode 7. We're going to stop the season on a lucky number here. 7, you know. And we're going to have the most sexual guest on Twitch, Cat Fucking Tidal Wave. So, let me get some exclamation applauses, you know, and then keep in mind you can do exclamation laugh, exclamation rim, you can just, you know, go crazy with the shit. But good evening, everyone. As you can see right here, thank you. You can see right here, I am going to be eating this tonight, right before the interview. I would like to apologize. Charlie cannot do the guitaring tonight. Sleepy Boy is sleepy. As everyone knows in the Discord, he needs his sleep, which is fine. It's fine. No biggie. We're still gonna just go on like normal. I am going to play a song. I have a song that I learned an hour ago just for Cat. Thank you. Hell yeah. I love this thing. But yeah. Let's start this off with Happy International Day Against Nuclear Testing. That is an actual international holiday today. Pretty cool. Yeah, nuclear stuff's, well, nuclear powers, all right, but yeah, no bombs. Bombs are bad. Let's start with some history, stuff that's happened on August 29th. So in 1728, Nuke Greenland was founded. That's, yeah, that's kind of interesting. Weird with the holiday going on, you'd think,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's not Nuketown, though. Not Nuketown. For all you COD fans out there, for all you Call of Duty fans, we're not talking about Nuketown, alright? We're talking about Nuke Greenland. In 1831, Michael Faraday discovered electromagnetic induction. Electromagnetic induction is how generators, cooktops, current clamps, guitar pickups, transformers, and more were made. So, like, I mean, fuck Elon Musk. I mean, Michael Faraday seems like the cool guy. Seems like Faraday probably fucked pretty good back in the day. August 29th, 1885, Gottlieb Daimler and Wilhelm Maybach made the first motorcycle. The first motorcycle with an engine. It was the Reitwagen. But who made the moped? See, that's the more important one. See, I love me a good moped. You know what I'm saying? 1898, August 29th, Goodyear was founded. Goodyear was named after Charles Goodyear, who actually died 40 years prior. 40 years prior to the Goodyear company.
It ain't got no gas in it.
What doesn't have gas? What, are you talking about the motorcycle? All right. But yeah, apparently the first stuff Goodyear made was carriage tires, horseshoe pads, and poker chips.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty interesting. And August 29th, 1966, the Beatles had their last show at Candlestick Park in San Francisco. Soon after, there was a guy who really liked Catcher in the Rye who decided to break up the band. You know, get into specifics about that one later. Yeah. Tell you what. August 29th, 1982, synthetic chemical atomic number 109, meitnerium, was made at Gesellschaft für Schwerioner Forschung in Darmstadt, Germany. Thank you. I'm not German, all right? I try. Apparently, meitnerium ain't used for shit. Ain't used for anything at all. In 1997, Netflix was launched. It's an online DVD rental service. I mean, that sounds cool and all, but personally, I think Blockbuster is going to be the one that really sticks around and keeps it going. You know, I think Blockbuster is going to stay number one for a long time. thank you. For birthdays, we have John Locke, we have Richard Attenborough, we have Tony McAlpine, and we got Michael Jackson, famous August 29th birthdays. And then we got a couple little news things. Let's see. Britney Spears and Elton John have released a new song on Friday. I heard that the new song is called "Hit Me, Benny and the Jets." Am I right? Yeah, apparently, it's just some like I don't know, some pop song. Thank you. You're on it today, drummer. Yeah. There's a new TikTok trend that has been hitting the internet by storm.
Fuck are you doing?
I'm doing the thing. I'm saying the stuff. It's okay. Right. New TikTok trend is asking servers to wear pigtails. Apparently, people think that pigtails get more tips. So I'm wondering if maybe I should start wearing pigtails in the kitchen. Maybe you think they'll see me back there with my pigtail? I don't have long hair anymore, but if I did, yeah, thank you. I know you think I'd look good with pigtails. Yeah. Studies say that young adults have been doing less clubbing and more crocheting. I tried to do this as well back at the beginning of pandemic stuff, and I'll just tell you, I cannot do anything involving that. I tried knitting, crocheting.
What the fuck are you
shit
doing?
Shit sucks. There ain't no way you catch me. Like I can't even do it. Can't do it. Can't even do a purl, or whatever they call it. In Twitch news, streamer Nolsky finished a Getting Over It challenge where even anything as simple as follows or 100 bits would reset the game. Apparently, it only took just under a decade to finish. Not really. It took less than a week, but probably felt like a fucking decade. And also in Twitch news, you can now stream on Twitch at the same time as other short-form content sites now. So, like, if you want to do, like, TikTok and Twitch at the same time, you can. Or Instagram and Twitch at the same time, you can. You just can't do, like, YouTube and Twitch at the same time because I don't fucking know. Whatever. Corporate bullshit. But, yeah, you know. Twitch news, and then the last Twitch news. Oh, we will. Twitch has changed their partner party times at the upcoming convention. Now, instead of the party going till 11, it'll only go till 9. And this is probably because those fuckers can't hang. Can't hang out till 11 p.m. Shit. Never survive in this bar. we have the one chip challenge. Yeah, and I'm gonna be playing guitar. We got fucking Cat Tidal Wave. He's gonna be here doing an interview. Hopefully I don't fuck it up too bad while I'm freaking out over this. But let's fucking go.
All right. So, I have a little bit of extra time. Mute? Am I muted? Still muted? Am I still muted? Yeah, don't do that shit. All right. I still have a little bit of extra time. So I'm going to play the song. That's what you get for the Rickroll. Eh, shut up. All right. Tonight's the night. Yeah, tonight. I'm worried more about the fucking chip. All right. Before I eat this chip, I have a song I'm going to play. I just learned it. Yeah. So we're going to see how this goes. Okay.
Sancho brought a message from the fat man. Sorry, boy, to leave you high and dry. But I went to see my mom in Ensenada, and I left a little something to help the time go by. Just a little something to help to keep you high. Bananas and blow.
Oh God.
Bananas and blow. Bananas and blow. Stuck in my cabana, living on bananas and blow. Now the rainy season reminds me of Maria. The way she danced, the color of her hair. Now I'm locked inside a stall in the cantina, eating the bananas and the cocaine off the mirror. Looking for a ticket to take me away from here. Bananas and blow. Bananas and blow. I'm stuck in my cabana, living on bananas and blow. Bananas and blow. Bananas and blow. Stuck in my cabana, living on bananas and blow.
Yeah, cat. time's up? Oh, I'm still kind of behind. Well, here's what we're going to do. We're going to go over here, okay? And I'm going to eat the chip a touch early, you know. Tonight's guest is going to fucking be the Cat Tidal Wave. Fuck yeah, just not quite yet, just not quite yet. He'll be here in a minute. No rush, no rush. No rush, no rush. There we go. Thank you all. I'm going to go ahead and get it open and stuff. But, yeah. We're taking this one slowly, y'all. Taking this one slowly. Okay. Alright, that's set. Now, here's another shitty thing. I don't have a glove for this. So, we're gonna see how that goes. I'm literally gonna use a napkin to hold it. Fuck. Come on, you bitch. Rub your eyes? No. Fuck. Fucking Christ. God damn it. We don't need a timer. We'll be good. Okay. Well. All right. Now we're just gonna hang out for a sec. Give Kat some time to come on by. You're good, Kat. You're good. I wanted to get the first few minutes where I can't even talk out of the way. Yeah, we'll go for an hour. Trying to get it all out of my teeth. Oh, the hand numbing's happening again. Whew. I'm crying. Okay. Oh, let me turn those on. Sorry. Huh? Okay, I still got hands. You're still there. Oh shit. Cat, welcome. Hey. Hey, what's up? You're a little quiet. I can hear you a little bit though.
Alright, let me turn up.
How you doing tonight, man?
I might be real loud now.
No, that's perfect.
Too loud for me. I'm going good, man. Going good.
Hell yeah, dude.
It's rainy outside. I went for a walk and now I'm a bit wet.
Oh, hell yeah. Hell yeah. That actually brings me to one of my first questions. What would you like me to call you this evening?
Call me, Longmont Potion Dingus.
Okay, Longmont Potion Dingus. Okay.
Mr. Dingus to you.
Mr. Dingus. Before we get started, let's let everyone know who you are. Would you like to take a sec and let everyone know who you are, what it is you do?
My name is Mr. Dingus. I am a philanthropist from Austria. I've been working in the healthcare industry for roughly the past 30 years, and it's a really rewarding job, and I get to help many people's lives and, you know, explore the world. It's pretty good.
Okay. Hell yeah. Well, how did you get the name, your Twitch name, Cat Tidalwave?
It came to me in a vision.
So okay.
One night, I laid my head down, and during the slumber, I had a vision. I was on the beach, right?
Mm-hmm.
And there was like a tsunami coming, or some might say a tidal wave coming at me. And the closer I got, I realized it wasn't made out of water. And it was actually a bunch, like millions of cats bellowing over the top of each other. Just row, row, row. And then it freaking crashed on me, man. And I was like, fuck, that's a cat tidal wave.
Interesting. Hell yeah. So tidal wave full of cats.
Yeah. How you going, man? How's your mouth going?
Oh, it's going great, man. I'm pumped up. Your words moved me. That's why I'm crying a little bit.
Man, I have an effect on
people. That's true, man. That's very true. Well, what got you into Twitch, Cap?
What got me into Twitch?
Yeah, like, how did you, first get on the platform? Like, what stuff were you first doing? How'd you first find the place? Stuff like that.
Man, it wasn't that long ago, but I have fully forgot.
It was
I think COVID happened, and then, oh, look at that, look at my
sub. Yo, Brad Sirs, thank you for the subs, dude.
Say thank you.
Thank you, dude, huh.
Jesus
but yeah.
Christ.
Rats yeah, but yeah, fungus COVID happened, girl. And I was like, all right, let's fucking do it, man. I got all this COVID money from girl. The government. The government was like, boom! COVID money, dude. And then, yeah, bought a computer.
Oh, so it was that recent. Okay.
Yeah, yeah, I started Jesus 2020. Ratsingers gave HVB 1183 a sub. Ratsingers
like, did, yeah, one sub to a did you, did you ever, like, watch Twitch or anything before that ever? Or was it,
I still don't watch Twitch.
Yeah, I feel that.
I never did it before, and I really Jesus don't Christ. Do it now. It's very rare Ratsers that I, like, sit down on this computer. I have turned this room into a fucking cesspool. Stale milk and shit and just cum and blood, and it's fucked, man, and I hate being in this room.
Yeah? hate the studio room? Christ.
God, I hate it. I wanted, like, Con Maria. Brat like, gifted a tier 1 sub. Doesn't make me Fitchimoto. Sparkle or whatever she says, but I'd be throwing out the whole fucking room. I can't do that.
When you do, like, so anytime you have watched it, what are some of your, who are some of your favorite streamers to watch?
Ratsuhers gave Smash underscore 42 a sub. Man, just going off
the list I got now.
Ratsuhers gifted a tier 1 sub to Smash underscore 42.
You know, your classic Amaranth?
Brad, thank you for the sub.
Big. Tier 3 Amaranth subscriber.
Okay, hell yeah.
Yeah, got it all, man. And I love, man, that's all I really watch. I don't really watch anyone else.
You so, it's, cause. Oh, yes, yes. I've seen your own.
A bunch of subs in the chat.
Thank you. Yeah. It's fucking good.
Time to ring that cum bell, bro. You
know what
I'm saying, dude?
Yeah, yeah. You gotta
knock some knees together.
Hell yeah, dude. I'm always ready to knock some knees together. You know me.
Amen.
What do you, whenever you don't hate the streamer room, what is it you enjoy most about streaming?
I'm gonna be super honest right now, dude. The money is really cool, right? I'm like, people will probably say like the community and fucking all this other shit, which is true. I love that shit, man. But money's like it's really relieving having just like a little bit of money, not heaps, you know, but just like a little bit. You know?
I feel that. Speaking of money, I have a shout out clip coming right here for Cat Tidal Wave. If anybody wants to go check him out or send him your money, please. Can Cat get louder? Can Cat get louder? I think the alerts.
One, two. Double flip, check. Double flip, check. Triple, double flip. Double flip.
I'll add a little bit of gain on my end. Oh, God. Holy fucking shit. All right, say something.
Let me ask you a few questions because you're going through a little bit of an experience right now.
Absolutely.
Okay. So what is your deepest, darkest secret?
Deepest, darkest secret?
Yeah.
It probably has something to do with, like, the old cum rag I used to keep under, like, a traffic cone that I had in my bedroom, and when I moved, well, I had this pair of boxers that I would just, you know, jizz all over, and I would hide it under a traffic cone, and when I moved out of that house, I panicked because I didn't know what to do with it, so I threw it in the attic. So there's just a pair of cum boxers in a random attic somewhere. Anyway, anything darker?
Yeah. What's the darkest thing you've ever done?
I had sex in a cave once, but I don't think that's pretty bad.
Okay.
That's pretty dark, though. I mean, it was dark in there.
You're not wrong.
Alright. So we've seen some shit. You've been in a band. I don't know if you are still. I've seen clips. I saw you knock your fucking tooth out. How long have you been into music?
What the fuck are you doing?
I think I got into music when I was like 15, maybe a little earlier. Pretty late compared to most of my friends. And I only got into it because my friends were doing it and they needed someone to play drums. So I was like, all right, I'll learn drums.
So and you started as a drummer.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hell yeah. Who's
not musical. Even to this day, it's all just fucking luck, man. It's all fucking luck. You don't need to know how to play an instrument. You just gotta like take your shirt off, shake a couple of titties, dude. Even if you're not a good musician, people are like, fuck, that band's pretty good. It's insane.
I've heard you play bass as well, right?
I played bass in a band a while back, but that band's not together anymore.
Okay.
I sing in this band.
Yeah, the
sing, you know what I mean?
Yeah, that's that. I was gonna say the clip I saw of you were singing. Looks very, very sexual, very good shit.
Yeah, full gimps. We all do full gimps, full
dude. Gimps. Fuck yeah, you can get away with that. That's nice,
it's beautiful, man. It's odd.
Who's your favorite band? I did that. I learned that an hour before stream and failed at it just for you.
Dude, Dude, it sounded great. It sounded great. Round of applause for Sid. That sounded fucking great.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
I was able to tell what it was. That's the number one rule of music. You can make mistakes, but as long as it sounds close enough, then you've done your job.
Absolutely. Right?
Anyone who says any different, is they're idiots. Trust me. I read a book once, man.
Have you have you ever seen Ween live?
No, man. I would love to see Ween live. I saw they just played in Colorado for like the South Park 25th anniversary thing.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Would have been fucking outstanding to go to, dude. But no, I've seen Dean Ween perform with Primus when they toured Australia, but I haven't seen Ween. They haven't been at it since like 2012, and I wasn't even into them back then.
What would you say is your favorite live show you've ever been to then? If you haven't seen Ween.
Man, I don't know. That's what I've been to fucking heaps. You know, probably some of my favorite live shows I've ever been to have just been like local bands.
I was going to say what, like I know. Yeah, I know, you know, we might not know them, but like what's a fucking awesome local band around you that kicks ass?
Fucking heaps of them, man. You've got like freaking, you know, my band that's fucking badass. And then you've got bands like fucking Basil's Kite. Right? Okay. Basil's Kite go fucking off. You got Trollhagen. If anyone listens to my stream, I pretty much only play local music when I play music.
So I have that Spotify list. Yeah.
Yeah.
The Cat Tidal Wave local bands.
Yeah. Any of those bands, there's a reason why I put them on the list because I do like them. Then you got like bands like Coffin. They're like oi punk. You know what oi punk is?
Is that a genre or is that a band?
It's like a genre, man. So it's like riffs which are just like real heavy, just like boom ka boom ka boom ka boom ka boom, like, and then just like ding, 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 ding. And then all the lyrics are just about like Australia, right? It's like this Australian genre, and a lot of the lyrics are, you know, well, you can get oi punk in like England and, you know, I think some of those colonial places, but dude, Australian oi punk, it's crazy because they just sing about like the environment and shit like that and how it's being fucked up, and then they go oi 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 dun-ka-dun-ka-dun-ka-dun-ka oi. I don't know, man.
What, oh dude, that's fucking sick.
It's fucking,
hell yeah,
so weird, man. I'm into it.
So
a lot of them, but yeah,
I was gonna ask that once you said, I was gonna say, have you ever heard the song that's like Smoko, I'm on Smoko, you know what I'm talking about,
dude? You kidding me, man? I go live on fucking... When I go live on fucking stream, dude, I get about fucking 5 smart-ass American motherfuckers coming into my stream being like, oh, you're an Aussie, mate. Hey, you ever listened to the song Smoke? Tame Impala. It's like, fuck off, dude. Shut up. I don't really like that song. I get what the band does, and it's cool, but I'm not too into it. It's a little too on the nose. You know,
okay.
Like, no,
fair
those
enough.
Guys don't sound like that when they talk. When if you're going to be like an Australian punk band and you're going to put that infliction on your voice, kind of like, oh yeah, fucking going down to the pub, gonna fucking, you know, if you're going to do that, you have to sound like that out of the record, or then you're putting it on and you're a little douche.
Speaking of douches, what's your opinion of AC/DC?
Yeah, they're cool. They played up in high school.
Shut the fuck up, really? Yeah, were you there?
No, I wasn't there. I wasn't there.
Oh, okay.
It was like fucking 30 years. It was like 1974 or something like that, right? And they did a whole tour of all the schools on the east coast of Australia. They might have went to the west coast, but that place doesn't really fucking exist. So if anyone ever tells you about Western Australia or Perth, fucking give them a little knocking around. Give them a little fucking 1-2. Because they got no idea what they're talking about.
Gotcha.
I get it. Whatever.
To move on from to music, did you have any sort of backgrounds in art, or did you do any like any kind of art stuff before streaming, before you started painting and stuff?
No, I really don't even like painting on stream. I really don't like art. I think it's pretentious and really. And like, I like it when people buy my art and I get it and it's fun painting with them, but I'm enjoying the progression of when I first started about a year ago painting to now when I'm painting, and sometimes they come out pretty good. So that's like satisfying for myself. It's like a growth, you know, from like doing something like as a joke, really, to making money off it and then getting good at it is a pretty cool, like, fun progression that I didn't think I was gonna do.
What about the meat sculpting? You into that? And are you
I love meat sculpting, dude. Yeah. If I could, I would be 100% meat sculpting stream. But I know I'd have so many people coming up to me being like, wee, 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 you're wasting food. There's people starving. Wee, wee. It's like, fuck off. You really think a couple of lugs of Devon are really going to change that? Like, get your head out of your ass. It's bigger than that, you motherfucker. So if I did that every single fucking day, I'd have people fucking, I'd have Peter on my back.
Hey, well, to be fair, I was going to say, to be fair, if people are eating that, they're going to need like a gallon of water with it because it's just salt and meat.
Dude, it's good, man. I love Devon.
Oh, I mean, I love Spam, which that's, I guess, similar. Too, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, the thing with Devon is it's got a different taste because it's not spiced, right? So it's just kind of like, it's just like ham, man. You know what I mean, dude? And it's delicious, dude. What you do is you put it in, on like, you. I think you guys call it a broiler. I just call it a grill. You chuck it fucking under the grill, right, where the elements are toasting it. It crisps up. And it's like bacon, man. It's like a bit of bacon. You know, get creative with it, you know?
Have you, what do you think the most sexual thing you have ever done is?
Man, just be who I am, dude.
Just being you? Just
be me, dude. I have been told that there's a 5 meter, like, proximity around me, where if you're within that bubble, you just fucking turned on all the time. And that is not even a lie. I'm being dead serious.
Just, well, have you ever had sex in public?
Yeah, I think I have. I might have been a little bit younger. Yeah, I have, like, outside in, like, the forest and shit like that, but...
I don't know if I... Know. Is the forest public? Would we call the forest public?
Like, I haven't had sex in, like, a vicinity of, like, people around.
Okay. So no bathrooms? Nothing, Well, no public bathrooms, I guess I would say.
You see, this is the thing.
Okay.
Right. The way I like to make love, right...
Okay. Here we go.
Yeah. ...is... It's not only intimate, right? Mm-hmm. But it's intense. And anyone who would witness that would fall to their knees in envy for only to wish they could have an experience as perfect as that one. So all my encounters are really, really isolated from the general public.
Gotcha. If you were too close and someone caught on, they might explode from sheer...
It's happened before, man. We gotta cover it up somehow, you know what I mean?
Oh, so that's your deepest, darkest secret, I'm guessing, is the person who exploded?
No, you wouldn't even want to get me started on that, man. I'm gonna go down that road tonight, okay?
That's fine. Alright, so here's my question. You stream, which is funny, here, my time, you are, I think you start at 10:30 or 11, my time?
At 1 p.m.
So yeah, 11. Yeah, 11. So, it's night here, you're just going ham at 1 p.m. afternoon time. What's your sleep schedule like? Do you actually, like, have a normal sleep schedule?
I have a beautiful sleep schedule. It's a little twisted right now because I've been doing I've just got a lot of hobbies that I'm doing, just like shit like that. That has been keeping me up at night. But normally, I try to get to bed 11-ish, right?
Okay.
And I try and wake up. I've been waking up at 10 recently, but normally I would try and do like 9, 8 or 9, hopefully, you know. Today was 9 because we have construction going on, so I got woke up by the construction dudes, but... Yeah, pretty healthy. You know, I finish stream and I go out, you know?
You probably have the most normal sleep schedule of a lot of people I know on Twitch.
Really normal life.
That, you know, yeah. I mean? Would you ever consider having kids?
Probably not, man. That shit's a little twisted. Like, you know, I always grew up fucking... I hate children now. Like, I'm 27 and I fucking... hate children, and I also hate old people, but let's not get onto that. But I really hate children, right? Mm-hmm. Sometimes they can be cute and I'm like, I get it, but I just don't think the payoff is worth it in the long run. You know, like, you have to take care of that motherfucking thing, dude. I got a cat. I'm good. I'm good, but maybe.
You can't imagine just some little fat wets running around looking just that like
the reason to have children. Would be like some form of world domination. Like three or four of me out with the freaking, you know, the tidal wave surname, right? The wet surname, right? Running around being sexual, fucking shit up. You know what I mean? Maybe I could fucking conquer some shit, you know? And the odds of one of them being successful has to be a little bit higher, right? They can give me some money, you know?
It's true.
That's the least they can do.
It's true. I mean, you never know. Every child's a potential lottery ticket or something.
Yeah, but, you know, you don't have to feed a lottery ticket.
Do you enjoy living in Australia? Is there any other place you've thought about, like, if you could leave, where you'd go live at?
Dude, Australia's fucking awesome, man.
Yeah.
Like, I love Australia, dude. It's chill as shit, man. Like, everyone... Most people are real relaxed. You run into some stress heads, but where I live, it's a city, but it's a pretty small city. There's only like 300,000 people, right? Which is considerably small. And you know, it's a coastal city, man. I live on the beach. Everyone's pretty down to earth, you know. You know, it's pretty relaxed. So
what's your favorite place to go in Australia? Like, what's your favorite some of your favorite spots?
Man, there's this fried chicken place where they have beer. I go there a lot, but I think you mean like actual places.
No, I mean, that works too, but I mean, I don't know. Like, yeah, I guess like a shitty tourist spot or like
Dude, okay, I got a perfect one, man. I grew up in a suburb called Winoona, right? Okay. Crazy to pronounce. Don't worry about it. And the beach there is so just beautiful. Every time I go there, I don't live there anymore. I only live like 15 minutes away. Not too bad. But every time I go to this specific like spot, I feel like I'm like, oh, there's like a wave of like power that's rushing through me. Fucking dope as shit, man.
Hell yeah. So just that wave of nostalgia pretty much, like from being there in the past kind of shit.
It's amazing, dude. It's amazing.
Nice. So I went ahead, by the way, I asked some of your mods to okay. give a Wanderbread, thank you for the sub to Ace. You know, I just wanted to get I won't say who gave me what question, but you know, we'll start with this one. What is it about feet that get you so bricked up?
What the fuck, dude? Man, it's those tiny little grippers, bro. You know, each one of those digits has a personality of their own. There's no escaping it, dude. There's no escaping it.
I don't know. I'm trying to think of a good Quentin Tarantino joke for that.
Here.
What's your favorite flavor of cum?
Yeah. I would have to say, you know, original's always good, but if I have like a bit of a sweet tooth, you know, I'll go for like something Scandinavian, right? So maybe Swedish cum or maybe like Finland or anything around that area. But if, you know, if I want a bit of cum with a bit of punch, you know, maybe a bit of kick to it, I'll probably go to somewhere like, you know, Sri Lanka or Pakistan or like India areas. Yeah.
Oh, okay. So you like all forms of cum. Just, you know, just depends on how you're feeling.
I'm not a big fan of Canadian cum.
Oh, okay.
It's just a little too fake. You know, it's like synthetic. You know, it's like the government made it to make us believe that Canada is actually a real place.
Fair enough. All right. Okay. I mean, I think Canadian cum's a little syrupy personally, but,
yeah.
So you mentioned West Australia earlier. I was under the impression that you, retconned the West Australia not being real. I've heard that you, my question was, do you really believe that West Australia is real or are you just pandering?
Can you repeat that whole question, please?
All right. In essence, I was told that you now say that West Australia is real, pretty much, on your streams. Do you believe...
This is a misconception.
Okay.
Yeah, Sid.
Yes.
If that's your real name. Okay. This is a misconception. Western Australia exists. Okay. But it's 2.5 inches above my butthole.
Oh.
And the... Okay, so you know how there's like that conspiracy... Well, conspiracy that like Australia doesn't exist, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that was formed by the American bureaucratic capitalistic system, right? To trick the American people into believing that there were still other British colonizations around, right? Because after the Civil War, it all went to fucking shit, right? So they needed a lie to convince people that Australia doesn't exist, okay? Right? But what ended up happening was that Australia did exist, but to the American people, and the closest way to get there is Western Australia first. Or Western Australia. So they were never able to see it. So that's where the myth started. So Western Australia doesn't actually exist, but East Australia, right, and the other states do exist. Right.
Okay.
But Western Australia is located 2.5 inches above my butthole.
All right. Well, okay. I think that's a great answer. I think whoever told me to ask that is going to love it. VB or Better Beer?
Yeah. Well, you know, what do you like better, chocolate or ice cream? You know, they're both pretty good, right? But they're better for different occasions, okay? So I've got like VB I generally drink normally because most pubs will have VB on tap, right? Mm-hmm. So that's kind of like my go-to beer. But if I'm feeling a little sick or a little fat, you know, or something like that, and, you know, I kind of want to lose a little bit of weight, I'll go to the Better Beer. You know, VB has more of a bitter, rich beer flavor. But Better Beer, it's fine, you know, either
way. What is Better Beer? Is Better Beer like more of a light beer?
Yeah, it would be, definitely. Definitely. Okay. It's kind of compared to like all American beer.
Okay.
Right? Like your Budweiser's, your I've had them all, and they're all weak, terrible.
So yes. Better Beer is still as like, it's like Budweiser, not even Bud Light.
Yeah, more Budweiser.
So VB, what American beer would you call VB? Have you ever had, I'm guessing.
You guys don't have anything like that.
All right.
Have some imports, which you could compare. But have you, do you...
I work at a brewery. I've not tried Vegemite.
So Vegemite and VB are very similar in like...
Really?
A unique experience. It's not as intense, but it's a unique experience that can only be like perceived from those two objects. Like you've got VB... Right, not, there's not much like it, because a lot of people say it tastes like piss, and maybe that's why I like it. I don't know, right? Is female ejaculate piss? Don't ask me, right? And then, what am I talking about?
Better Beer, VB. Oh, Vegemite. Vegemite and VB. Yeah.
Unique.
All right.
Yeasty.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeasty. Unique. Yeah.
Okay. All right, then I have Fuck, Marry, Kill, Incognito, Sam Hatch, and Phallus.
Marrying Phallus,
okay.
Right? That dude is ready to settle down. You know,
absolutely.
He's a real chill dude. He's got a job, right? He's got a nice job. He lives in a nice set. He's ready to just relax. You know, he's smart. I love everyone, but I'm being real. I'd marry him. Okay, now who am I fucking and who am I killing between Sam and Incognito, huh? I reckon I will, The ideal would be a human centipede between the three of us. But I get the game and I respect the rules.
Sure.
Okay, so let's have a look here. I think what I would probably do... Oh, man. You know what? This is a really fucked up answer, right? But I'm going to give it a sincere, right, and thought out, you know, I'm fucked. Okay.
Anyway, sure.
So I'm actually going to kill Incognito for one reason only, man. Sam's got a family. He's got kids. You know, I got to think about the future, man. I love Incognito. I fucking love him a bit, but I got to think about this logically, right? I got to think about this like he's a human, just not a name in a game. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
fucking the shit out of Sam. I'm gonna freaking dick that dude out so hard, man. He'll have a freaking cavity growing inside his fucking gut.
Hell yeah. That's what I like to hear. And, you know, it just can't, it never goes on long enough. But my last question, Kat, or sorry, Mr. I was in spice hell. Mr.
Longmont.
Longmont potion.
Whatever.
Yeah. If you died.
Mr. Dingle.
Yeah, there we go.
Mr. Dingle,
if you died right now, what accomplishment in life would have made you the most proud?
I'm just a likable guy. But that's pretty cool.
Being to walk the earth.
Fucking sexual, thick hugged motherfucker in the whole world. That. And probably touring like Malaysia, Indonesia, Singapore, Thailand.
Whoa, man! Imagine if I could lactate.
Really fucking cool.
Hell yeah, man. Well,
we played to all the flood victims in Indonesia.
Dude, that's fucking sick. That's actually really nice.
It's actually pretty good.
Well, shit, man. That's pretty much all I got. Is there anything you want to plug? Anything you wanna fucking
No, I don't really do too much.
Yeah, that's
fine. Whatevs. Like, who cares? You know.
Well, hell yeah, dude. Wait, what?
Make sure you check out my charity, right? Over in Austria, I am a philanthropist, as I was saying earlier, and I am working on a book called "The Memoirs of a Geisha." Now, it's gonna be probably out by next September 11th is the date that we're aiming for. The book's going to be pretty good. It's going to, it's going to blow up on the shelves, and it's just going to be an amazing, amazing book. So thank you so much, guys. Let's get a bunch of subs and bits in the chat for fucking Mr. Big Dick Sid. Are you kidding me, dude?
Oh, man.
This was fun. I actually had fun.
Man. Hell yeah. I'm glad.
But
I'm gonna work on that myself now. I wanted to get through with that shit first,
amen.
But dude, thanks for coming by, man. That was fucking awesome.
Thank you, dude. This was actually really fun. You stay nice and sexual, okay, my friend?
You too, dude. Have a good one.
All right, talk to you later, baby.
And here's the funny thing. I